first collage show at the Stable was in 1953, and it was a kind of, well, it was very well received because it was very new in the sense that up to that time, collage had been used in a very minimal way by artists like Picasso and many other artists possibly, Matisse. They used it as decoration, they used it as studies, they used it as examples of what they could be doing, but they didn't do it as a serious art form. It was the few painters that were doing collage in that area then were very small, and usually it was paper, and it was involved in that way. The difference between my work was that they were major paintings, they were giant paintings, and they were done in canvas, and they were, in fact, on such a large scale, because I used collage not as a method of bringing in foreign matter into the painting, not bringing in excerpts from life into the collage and all that that later has happened. I wanted collage to be a way of painting, which it was for me. It was the clearest way that I could find to get the edges of the volumes I wanted to delineate, and it also gave me the possibility of working over and over a painting without it getting stale, because the collage, each time you add a piece, it's fresh. I was very happy that I won the Chicago Art First Prize, the Chicago Institute, and which the year before, I think they were doing it every 2 years, but 2 years before, Bill de Kooning had won. Then in 67, I was glad that the Whitney Museum offered me a retrospective, which I got. And that retrospective also was very well received. I've never felt myself as an abstract expressionist per se. I felt that the figure to me was always very important, and that the idea of not painting the figure as a law against it irritated me. I felt that whatever you want to paint, whether it's a figure, a still life, a landscape, they're all possible solutions to the problem that you may want to express. And since painting for me has always been like a problem to solve, I feel that the concept of space, the concept of form, all these are very vital, and they can be used more for me when I have some subject that I'm working with. The best way for me would say to get rid of the element of the figurative is by starting a figure and slowly finding its forces that will possibly destroy it, and sometimes leaves part of it. It's a figure, and I work with it until it becomes a painting. It becomes the image of the painting, becomes the painting, and not the figure that I'm painting. Then I feel more satisfied with it, and I have worked that way consistently through the years, and at times I explore other possibilities and find some kind of relaxation by doing it, because I can go back and forth. And that's the way I've worked all my life. I don't have one thing I do. That's why I've often said I don't believe in evolution in painting for myself as an artist. I don't believe that I'm doing anything today any better than I did 50 years ago. I'm just concentrating. Whatever the problem is, I'm concentrating on it. And I hope that I solve it as well as I can. Experience is like having a ticket to a train that has already left. And you have that feeling that it's not very useful anymore, because the experience that you have of one occasion, especially in painting, cannot be necessarily used to make a better painting later. The only thing you learn is that you learn that you're going to make mistakes. You learn that your painting is not going to come out. So you're not so surprised that you have an idea that this painting in red and blue is going to be fabulous, and then you paint it and it doesn't look right, and you're expecting it. You know that that could be. But maybe you have to start with something. You have to start with some idea of what you want, and by changing and moving it around, and of course that's where my working with collage has been very helpful, has taught me to think that way. In fact, the old story of how painting is a dialogue between you and the canvas becomes so very true, because so many times the canvas just insists that you don't do that. And so now I know that, and so it gives me the possibility, as I say in collage, the freedom and the courage that you don't necessarily have when you're painting. In the collage, you can do that. I could take a shape or three shapes of color and put them right over it and try them out and see if I like it. If I don't like it, take it off. So this gives me this great inventivity of courage. I can change a painting in half. I say, you know, I don't like that section. Let me see if I cover it. I cover it with three other shapes. Do I like it better or not? Or it prompts me to some other change. Abstract Expressionism was the closest thing that America ever had towards making its international reputation based on art values. The Abstract Expressionist was not working as a revolutionary, trying to tear down old gods. There was nothing like that. In the studios that I may have mentioned before, of whether it was Gorky or de Kooning or myself or Klein, they had hanging on the wall the Matisses, the Picassos, and the Renaissance painters. The Uccellos and the Piero della Francescas were there. In Rothko's studio, you'd find a Piero della Francesca hanging on the wall. So this showed there was not a revolution against art. It was what it was meant to be, that in every generation, art should have to offer an equivalent of an art form, an equivalent of what has been done before beautifully, and you do it in the next generation with your terms, but the same values are respected. If we had a situation which abstract expressionism had offered, it was offered to grow. It was meant to grow. At first, they may have clung only to the drips and that, but it could have grown into so many other possibilities that the painter can work in. But one has to have a kind of channeling of these forces. You cannot have anarchy in painting. As Oscar Wilde said, beware of being too modern because you become old-fashioned too soon. And I think that in most cases, artists find other artists' work. Their work correlates, and so they're inspired by other artists and other artists. And that is where, in fact, the growth comes in, because all art is subject to each other. All art depends on others. Nobody invents painting. It's every year, it just paints and goes on and it comes out of the past.